제115회 받으면 집으로 갖다 주세요.
Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly. Hey, are you ready to start another day of Korean culture, fun, people and language?
I am and I hope you are too. Welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I am your 훈장 Kim Young. It's good to have you guys here and it's good to have this man in here every single time. Well, how are you, Blake?
I am doing very well indeed. 안녕하세요, I'm Blake, and you're learning right along with me, so let's have some fun together.
All right. You know, in previous seasons, we had many guests, like, changing every other week or so.
Yeah.
This time, we've got Blake from the start to the end. How's it feel? Let's go and check out our lesson today.
아리랑 TV 시청자 여러분 안녕하세요. 배틀 크리스입니다. 오늘 제가 알려드릴 문장은요. 다 되면 집으로 갖다 주세요. 천천히 읽어볼까요? 다 되면 집으로 갖다 주세요.
다 되면 집으로 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Alright, I know it sounds really long, but actually it's quite easy. Let's go through it together. You hear some words that we already know, right? 주세요, 주세요 is give it to me. We also hear the word 집. In there,
it's home.
And then when you say 집으로, it's to the home, right? To home, 집으로. So let's put this all together. 다 means everything, okay? 다. All right? And then when you put it together with 되면, 되다 is to be something. But here we're saying when it's all done, okay? When it's all done, 다 되면, 면 is if. Okay, 다 되면 집으로, to my home, 갖다 주세요. And it's to bring it to my home. In other words, delivering it, right? Delivering to me. You can do this, for example, when you take your clothes to a dry cleaner's. What do? You drop it off, and then you tell them when it's done, bring it to my house, deliver it to my house. Another instance is we've been repairing our, you know, our watch, our cell phone, our computers these days. So when you drop it off at the repairman, not only can you pick it up, but you can also tell them to deliver it to me when it's done. So in this situation, you can use this sentence. Say it with me. 다 되면...
다 되면
집으로
집으로
갖다 주세요.
갖다 주세요.
Right.
Okay. Let's check this out. Something으로 갖다 주세요. Noun으로 갖다 주세요. Well, the 으 goes in before 로 if the phrase ends with a consonant, right? So 집 ends with a consonant, the B sound. So it goes 집으로 갖다 주세요. Now check this out, though. This is kind of strange. 사무실 사무실 is an office, right?
Right.
사무실, when you use that into this, it ends with a consonant, but you take out the 으. So it just becomes 사무실로 갖다 주세요.
사무실로 갖다 주세요.
도서관, which is a library, that ends with a N consonant. So you would say 도서관으로 갖다 주세요.
도서관으로 갖다 주세요.
Exactly.
Let's try one without the 받침 though. You work at a school,
yeah.
right? What if you were outside your school, you delivered some laundry and said, okay, bring it to my school when it's all done. How would you say that?
다 되면 학교로
갖다 주세요.
갖다 주세요.
네. 갖다 주세요 is take it or bring it to me. So you need to memorize this, okay? 갖다 주세요.
갖다 주세요.
네. 주세요 is just give it to me. So that kind of sounds strange, right? Instead, we want to say bring it to me.
I see. Okay, so 갖다 주세요. Bring
네.
it to me.
All right, let's go and review that second expression. 네, 알겠습니다. You know, when I get the impression I get is like you're in the army. 네, 알겠습니다. This is like when someone's giving you a command and you're affirming, yes, I will do that, all right? 네, we already know, like a positive affirming whatever the person says, right? And then the 알겠습니다, 알다 is usually I know, right? But this is like a spin-off from that word. 알겠습니다 is a higher, more respectful way, and it's saying yes and affirming whatever the person says. So if I told you to do something and you're in agreement with it, you just say 네, 알겠습니다. 공부 열심히 하세요. Study hard.
네, 알겠습니다.
Blake, you like that cute stuff up there, huh? Those mandarin oranges are yummy?
Yeah, they're delicious.
Okay, when you're through with that, 갖다 주세요, okay? 다 되면 갖다 주세요. 여기로. Bring it here.
네, 여기로. 알겠습니다.
Ah, thank you. I like this delivery service here.
Lisa, can I have some of that? 여기로 갖다 주세요.
Ah, Blake, 저기로 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Take it to him. All right, ooh, good service.
Thank you very much. Oh, Blake, you know what? I changed my mind. 저기로 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Delivery man today.
You know, I could really get used to this.
Actually, put it over there. Can you put it over there? No, just kidding.
You know what,
Sit down.
I'm kind of thirsty right now. 물 좀 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Come on. You said you like 녹차.
Oh my goodness. Look at this place.
This place is the Bosong Nokchabat.
Oh, it's so fresh and clean and
You can smell the aroma, huh? Well, Bosong Nokchabat, which is Bosong green tea fields, is responsible for over 40% of all the green tea produced in Korea. Not only is this area known for the quantity of green tea produced, but also the quality. It's legendary. Wow, you know, you actually like ice cream, don't you?
Oh, sure.
Exactly. They have 녹차 ice cream or green tea ice cream. And they also have green tea 삼겹살 for those people who are health conscious. Now, look at these fields. Oh, you know what? They might also be familiar because these fields came out in a drama called The Scent of Summer, 여름 향기. The first question in this test, say this in Korean using what you learned today. Deliver it to my home after it's all finished.
다 되면 집으로 갖다 주세요.
Here's a second question. Say this in Korean. Yes, I understand.
네, 알겠습니다.
네, 알겠습니다. Very good, Blake.
When it's all done, when it's finished, please deliver it to my home. 다 is everything. 되면 is when it's done. So when everything's done, 집으로, to my home, 갖다 주세요. 갖다 주세요 is to bring it there. So, in other words, to deliver it to my home, right? 네, 알겠습니다. 알겠다, 알다, all of this means to know, to understand. So here, 네, 알겠습니다 means yes, got it.
Get her some water. 물 좀 갖다 주세요.
물 좀 갖다 주세요.
No, you know what? I'm putting my foot down. I've been running around
getting stuff. Hey. 물 좀 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Do it for the lady. Thank you.
This is the life, isn't it? Blake, where's my water? 물 좀 갖다 주세요.
네, 알겠습니다.
There we go. All right, we'll see you guys next time on LSK. Bye-bye. 안녕히 계세요.